Good morning. So we're going to talk about color, but the first thing I wanted to do was to make you all a little bit uncomfortable this morning. So would you all agree to participate in creating something collectively? Yeah? Okay. So this is going to be based on something, a choice that you made this morning that you probably gave very little consideration to. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to arrange the room according to the color of shirt that you're wearing. Okay, so if you would all stand up, and you can just make it as simple as possible, bring your coffee and muffins, but here's what we're going to do. So if you, now we have a lot of black today, so if you are one of those people, have a look. We're going to have black people, black people. People with black shirts sitting over here in the chairs, please. Anyone, and group yourself together at tables. So anyone with red, reds and oranges, we're going to have come up here in the front. Pinks, you with the pink shirt, yes, you can hover up here. Okay, and then we're going to go according to the rainbow. So blacks, darks over here, reds. Oranges, group yourself together. Okay, where's our orange people? Great, you guys can sit up here. Yellow, you might be alone here. Greens in the middle. And then blues and purples and whites towards the back. Okay? So find a table, have a seat. You're gonna just pick another table and sit with people who are wearing similar colors to you. Okay, beautiful, almost there. Okay, do we? Okay, all right, so have a seat. Thank you. Now, I love this because I'm an artist and I'm often thinking about the effect that my work has on the audience. And now you all are just, you're having an effect on the artist, so thank you. Now, color is something that actually affects us in so many ways all the time, every day. And it's often something that we give very little thought to. So what I'm proposing this morning is that we reconsider the way that we engage with color. Now, before we do this, I want to tell you a little bit about myself and what I do to help you understand how we're going to be talking about color this morning. So like Lotta said, I'm an artist, and I like to call myself several things. So an artist, a guide, and a psychocartographer. Now, I'm an artist because I do these things. I make paintings and drawings. And I like to say that I'm a guide because part of the way that I think about creativity and art making is that in order for anything new to emerge, we have to step into new territory. And usually stepping into new territory or someplace we've never been requires getting a little bit uncomfortable. And it means that we're going to have to step into the darkness and some chaos in order to find that new thing that is waiting to emerge. And this is something that runs through most of my work. And I don't actually make art for art's sake, but I'm more interested in art and the creative process as something that can help us to teach us about ourselves and who we are. Now, the third thing that I call myself is a psychocartographer. And if we break this word down, the first part is psycho, not because I'm completely crazy, but because of this word psyche or psyche. Because I'm really interested in our internal experience, in how we experience the world, and how we make sense of the world around us, and how all of the experiences we've had shape and affect our sense of who we are in the world. Okay? Now, cartography is about making maps. And so with the images I make, I'm really interested in how can we and how can I make our experiences visible? How can we create evidence of our experience that helps us to navigate the territory that we're in? And so I do this for myself, and I do it for others. And one of the ways I've done it for others is through this project, Field Guide to the Czech Psyche. So 5 years ago, I moved to the Czech Republic because I had this desire to better connect to who I was. So I have Slovak ancestors. And so I came here really interested in, you know, what were those missing pieces of my own identity? What are the ways that having ancestors who came from this place have shaped my own sense of self? So I'm always interested in these questions of who are we? But then I'm also interested in, once we have a better sense of who we are, how can we then move forward into new territory? And like I said, that usually means we're going to have to make ourselves a little bit uncomfortable. So I decided to make myself a lot uncomfortable, and I made a whole project about being here, Field Guide to the Czech Psyche. I decided I would, you know, land in a foreign country where I didn't know anyone, where I didn't speak the language, and I would make an entire project out of it. So I spent years asking questions about, what does it mean to be Czech? You know, how does our identity affect our sense of self in the world? Right, so I came here and I started looking back, and then I used my art as something to help me move forward, to help me step into new territory. So this morning, what I want to do is have us consider that maybe what's better is not that I stand up here and tell you about color this morning and what color is and what color does, but instead pose the question of what can color teach us about ourselves? What information can color give us about who we are and what new territory we'd like to step into? Now, to do this, I want to introduce you to this phrase that I love, which is, the way we do anything is the way we do everything. Okay? So the way we do anything is the way we do everything. So we're going to explore color through these methods of looking back, who are we? And then looking forward, who are we becoming, or what new territory are we stepping into? So there's two ways that we're going to do this. First is looking back. So color, what can you tell us about ourselves? Now, to talk about this, we're going to have to talk about my 3-year-old niece, Anna. So Anna is 3, and from the day this little girl could articulate and name colors, she's had a favorite color. And Anna's favorite color is purple. If you ask Anna what dress she wants to wear, it's purple. Ask Anna about her favorite color, it's purple. It's always purple. And I find this utterly fascinating. You know, that as little beings, we come into the world with this sense of what we love and what we're intuitively drawn to. And color is a really powerful way that this shows up for us. You know, in the same way that if I were to ask you now, what color would you never wear? What color do you hate? I sense that all of you would have a pretty definite, strong answer for me. Now, the second thing that starts happening is, you know, we're these little beings and we have this sense of who we are and what we love and how we naturally want to express ourselves. And then that starts to become conditioned and tempered by the world around us, right? This is just what happens. People start telling us what's appropriate or acceptable. The society we live in has ideas about what colors are appropriate. The traditions from our culture, right? This is why most of us don't wear pink to a funeral. And when I was thinking about this, I was looking back at my own life. And a couple of instances where my sense of how I naturally wanted to express myself was conditioned by the world around me. So I remember being in kindergarten. So I was 5-year-old little Jessica, and I was getting ready for school. And I got myself up, and I got myself dressed, and probably didn't think much of it. But I marched down the stairs with my little bowl haircut, and I walked into the kitchen where my mother was making breakfast. And my mother took one look at me, and very sweetly and kindly, she looked at the red pants I was wearing and the pink shirt. And she said, "Oh, sweetie, I'm sorry, you can't wear pink and red together." So I marched back up the stairs and changed, and surely she was trying to protect me from being teased or what other people might think. And then a couple years later, I was getting dressed for church one morning, and I had put on a black skirt and a navy blue shirt. And again, I marched down the stairs and was greeted by my mother, who looked at me very sweetly and said, "Oh, sweetie, you can't wear black and navy blue together." And it's not like these are dramatic, life-changing moments, but we all have these experiences where our natural sense of how we want to express ourselves, right? Our intuitive relationship to color is conditioned by the world around us. And I think that most of us as adults go through this process of actually really trying to reconnect to our intuition, right? Trying to reconnect to how is it that we really want to express ourselves. And so, I totally forgot what I was going to say next. Give me a minute. So, when we start looking back at color, what is it telling us about who we are? It has some really interesting information to give us. And I also think that it's really interesting because one of the comments that I most frequently get about my paintings is that people love the colors. Now, in my paintings, this is an area where I let it be completely intuitive and spontaneous. And I've actually used color as a way to reconnect me to my intuition. So when I'm planning a painting, I'm not thinking to myself, you know, what color would be appropriate, or how is this going to affect my audience? I really let it be completely intuitive and spontaneous. And it's one of the things that people respond to the most. So after we look backwards about what can color tell us about ourselves, we then can start looking at what new territory can color push us into. And how can color be a tool that helps us to go to new places? And doing this usually requires us getting a little bit uncomfortable. When I was in grad school, I had this amazing class called Creativity and Consciousness. And one of the exercises was our professor asking us to do something in our creative practice that we would otherwise never do. So essentially, he was asking us to make ourselves really uncomfortable and do something we essentially hate. Now, what happened for most of us is that we decided to work with a color that we would otherwise normally never work with. So people started doing bodies of work based on blue because they hated blue. And it became this really powerful exercise for a lot of people. Because oftentimes, the things that we hate and we reject and we avoid are actually something about ourselves that wants to be integrated. It's about some aspect of ourself that we've said no to, that once we start to say yes to, we often discover a lot about who we really are. Now, around this time, I discovered this performance artist, Linda Montano. And Linda Montano's thing is doing these really long endurance performances. And in the first performance that I learned about, she tied herself together with another artist using an 8-foot rope between them for an entire year. So for an entire year, they had to do everything together. They couldn't go to the bathroom without ever closing the door. They couldn't get in the elevator without making sure the other person was in it. And so I love these kinds of projects and experiments that essentially really make us uncomfortable. But imagine how much they learned about each other in the process. Now, the next project she did was a 7-year performance. And for 7 years, each of those years, she only wore one color. So for the first year, her entire wardrobe, everything she wore from head to toe, was red. Only red, every day, all year. And she based this on the chakra system, or basically the rainbow. So for 1 year, she wore red. The next year, only orange. And then yellow, and then green. So for 7 whole years. And I think this is brilliant, and it's such a beautiful example of creating some kind of project, some kind of way to really push ourselves into new territory and to explore these parts of ourselves that are uncomfortable or have to wear purple for an entire year. Don't tell my niece Anna, but I would be mortified. Okay. So this morning, going back to this phrase, the way we do anything is the way we do everything, I decided that I wasn't just going to come up here and talk to you about color, but that we should collectively make a project about color and about what territory color can push us into. So I have an invitation for you all. And my invitation is this. So this weekend, I want you to ask yourself and answer the question, what color would I never wear? Would I never want to wear? You know, what color is just absolutely horrifying to you? And then I want you to buy or borrow or whatever you have to do to get a piece of that color into your wardrobe. And then you're going to wear that color one day next week, for the entire day. Okay? Now, a project isn't a project really, unless there's some documentation of it. So the invitation, and Creative Mornings and I have teamed up with Vivo Leto. And what they do is they print out Instagram photos. So the invitation for you is to wear that color that makes you really uncomfortable, feel however you feel all day, and really pay attention to that. And at some point, take a photo of yourself, and you're gonna post it to Instagram using these hashtags. So, I hate you color, CM Prague, and Vivo Leto. Now, Vivo Leto will print out these photos, and then I will invite you to my studio. I will invite you to my studio to tell me all about the horrible, or interesting, or really enlightening day you had wearing a color that you absolutely hate. And for those of you who can't make it to my studio, we'll have these photos for you at the next Creative Mornings. Okay? So what color do you hate? And let's go for it. Let's make ourselves really uncomfortable. So to close, I'm just gonna leave you with this other phrase that I love, which is that everything we truly desire lies just outside our comfort zone. Thank you.